At center, we got Miss Amanda Vincent. At forward, we got Miss Cassandra Hewitt. And at our other forward, we got Miss Diana Minton. The junior girls are coached by Miss Robin Simons. And now for our senior girls. At guard, we got little bitty Miss Tyra Taylor. At our other guard, we got Miss Becky Reekin. At center, we got the big, the man, Robin Sturgeon. Olivia Van Meter. The senior girls are coached by Brandy Meredith and Stephanie Minton. Enjoy the game.
Yeah!
seniors ball.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
4.
Stop it! 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 Stop basketball. Of course, we're going to win. Our team is. So.
I almost got married. She had a move. She's
making love. Where the hell's the next baby? Yeah. I stuck up behind me. Christmas
night. Listen to Bush. Listen to Bush in the front. I'm ready. I'm only got hit once.
Stephanie. Huh. Going up the volleyball now. Stephanie. She's got
a shirt on. She's got the front of her.
What is he doing? He didn't have any
ball. Oh, we don't. There's a ball from down here.
Yeah.
Watch him out.
Edward's out of bounds. Shot! give me some. The big man and the big man. My back's hurting.
I'm fixing that mess seat somewhere.
I'm fixing to go back in the office for a minute. We have still got an hour and 43 minutes. Is it only 2 o'clock now?
Thank you. program. The Senior Banquet Committee has composed and remembered the poetic form of the class of 96. On prom night, we all saw Jason Klein, who was dressed up and looking so fine. But his girlfriend had to go to Walmart, so in his uncle's wardrobe, she did depart. As a new face among the crowd, John Violence was so full of questions. He lost his license, it did astound, probably because he made so much objection. Dark Club went to Chicago to view some valleys and Greco. Emily and her buddy had a cadre egg fight in their hotel room that night. Softball practice can be a blast. Now they do look through the ball and right, but by its catcher it passed, and on Woody's head it did a lot. Talk about people who changed. Wasn't it Stacy, April, Jenny, and Seth who sang the two-pack song to Nick? Boy, did he grow up slick. We shall never forget Junior Bank Convention when Jennifer, Shauna, and Amber, their parents, misled on pretense to Louisville they went, but Aerosmith's concert was their intent. Broken bones are a part of school life. Ask Donald Goins, who took it on the job with a baseball bat and brand new swat, for that pitching machine has quite a claw. There are those of us with great distinction, like Ty with his pant leg rolled up to perfection. Robin, whose life is only surpassed by and men at Big County because of his funky haircut. Let's not forget Wayne's most distinctive brand name labels, and Summer whose typing speed teachers task enables. And there's the courage of Jennifer Dickens, whose triumph is a personal conviction. And now, if Hillary Vincent will come forward, please, she will be singing A Bad Goodbye.
Especially when his tray was overhead thrown.
As he slipped and fell to the floor, his lunch all over him did pour. And Telltale, so true, made Stephanie and Brandy boo-boo. Audie just had to squeal. To Miss Mary Alice, the candy deal. Excuse me. And on the bus, it was Jeremy Hodges who got his gum and his hair to lodge. So tight was it made again that only the cut of the pocket knife undid. Brady Rentrell's black stallion was more than Jenny Spayhower can handle. So over the seat, Brady did soar to mash down the brake pedal. It was that standby whiteout that caused Mr. Warnell to shout, "Jane Hoover, sandpaper you will use to make my guests just like me."
Was it only 7 years ago that Chadwick's buckle dropped so low as to splash the toilet wet and deceive the beaver he would break? Trapper the actor, par excellent, he has portrayed new audience roars, his Benny falling from a branch, and Tom sporting a smiling face on his drawers. Clothes represent students' interests, like Wes Miller's shirts of kids, and everything's just got to be ho-ho if it's going to be warm with Scott Bledsoe. If you hear someone talking aloud, you can bet it isn't bright pretty. Talk about being one of the crowd, why he's your hilarious. A game in softball summer league led to an accident unforeseen, when Alicia ran fast to catch the ball and cut her leg severely in a fall. Bruce made Paul bite oh so well, those who ate a pig did tell that it was some Mexican dish for the recipe they did wish.
Car antics have consumed much of our lives. Wasn't it Randy Clark's new car that took a dive? And Jeremy sailing through Axel Road while Kevin Davis has to have his smoke. Before his arrived, we didn't know how long John Starn's tongue was. Because before class one day, he gave a speech. Unfortunately, his mouth began to run. But don't fear to stop it, his tongue did reach. In kindergarten, David Rich was such a bully. Kissing April on the cheek, he made her cry. Said her, he said, "I'll give something for which to cry." I call Maddie, get her in the mirror. One event that stands out so nice is senior student day in that pair of guys. Tanya and Stacy wore snake eyes, so scream. But to throw them, no one would dare. This class has created its own word. It can mean dumb, silly, bad looking, or nerd. When something is really undescribable, we just blurt out, "He's a perv." Class of 96, we all agree, is about to be set free. So let us not forget one another, but we'll always be ECHS sisters and brothers. And now it's an honor to present to you Natalie Gould, Jamie Johnson, and Travis Parsley singing "The River."
I could burn on the wind.
good Lord as my cat, I can make it to tomorrow. I will sail my last till the river runs dry, like a bird on the wind. These waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I
Please park your chair.
These two girls are receiving an award because there's a couple of mice. There's coins and mice. Dixie Carroll and Michelle Harrison, come on down and get your award for your super silent. Our next award is quite different from our preceding award. A lot of girls giggle, but she out-giggles them all. Stacy Ray, come down and pick up your Giggle Box Award. This award goes to a young lady for her skilled leadership and ability to perform all tasks up to potential and office systems. The Director of Services Award goes to Rebecca Rigdon. The next award is for a young lady's outstanding voice and performance as a devoted choir member. The Senior Choir Member Award goes to Heather Tucker. This award is to prophesy that this young man's future health problems will rely on a lifetime supply of arthritis pills for his constant certificate of effectiveness goes to Mr. Wolfman.
I can never those places can become entwined with violence. I'm begging you tonight, class 96, not to become one of the statistics that you hear about every day. After graduation, I may never see many of you again. I hope that throughout the years I hear no negative news about any of you. I want each and every one of you to prosper throughout your lives and always be happy. I want to say thank you to my mom and dad for putting up with me through 13 years of education, from crying every day in kindergarten to taking me to catch the bus for a ballgame at high school. You are two very special people that I will always love and admire. No matter how I look it, I'll always be your little girl. Thank you, Tyson, for always sticking by my side. You gave me the courage to press on, and you had faith in me even when I had none of myself. I hope the rest of our years together will be as happy as the past two and a half. Finally, thank you, class 96, for becoming some of the greatest friends ever.
As our final year comes to a close, I realize that our paths will be parting, and each of us will be taking different roads to our future. Over the years, I've made many friends, some of which I'm closer than others. I would like to thank my special friends, Jenny, Stephanie, and Autumn, for being there to share secrets, memories, laughs, and tears. The bond that we have made will be forever in our hearts and minds. I owe many thanks to my mom, Dad, and Anthony. For encouragement, support, and love that have helped me to reach the goals that I've set in my life. As a part of the class in 1996, I know that I may never see many of your faces again. But no matter how far we may stray, we must always remember our years together. We are and always will be proud to be Edmonson County High School's class of 1996. For this reason, we will always have a common thread that binds us together in our hearts and memories, no matter where we may be. Mine may be a little bit longer than the others, but I just had so much to say. It seems like it was just yesterday that I began my life traveling down a long path that I thought would never end. Kindergarten began as I clung to Mom's hand, not seeming to realize I was about to take just one of the many steps I must take down life's path. Elementary days quickly faded, and then I moved on to middle school. Friends came and went, and I seemed to grow and develop into my own person. Then at last it was time to face high school. Scared to death from all the horror stories I had been told of being slammed into lockers and thrown into garbage cans, I didn't seem to realize the true meaning behind the place. It is not a place filled with terrible happenings, but to me, a place that holds my most cherished memories and friends that were always there to laugh when something was funny or lend a shoulder when something went wrong. As I stand here before the class of 96, I just want to say thanks. Thanks for all the memories and loving friends, especially April, Brandy, Jenny, and Autumn. I may know some of you better than others, but all of you have touched my life in some way. You have meant so much to me, and now that our days together as a class are almost over, I seem to realize just how special people can be. To the Edmonson County High School faculty and teachers, I want you to know that all your help and guidance is greatly appreciated. I'm so glad to find a friend in each of you that I know will listen when I need or have a problem. A very special thanks goes out to my mom, stepfather, and pal. Without all of your love and encouragement, I would have never made it where I am today. You're always there to push me to keep striving to reach my goals. Without you, I would have probably given up. To me, you are the best, and everything you have given me is greatly appreciated. And last, but definitely not least, I would like to thank God. For without Him, everything I have accomplished would have never been possible. He has blessed me in so many ways, and no matter how hard I try, I can never repay Him. Not only is He been my guide down life's path, but He is someone that I know will never leave me. Well, as we all depart from here tonight, I think we have all found the true individual that lies within each of us. No two people are alike, but together, as a class of 96, we are very special and unique.
Over the years, we've had our differences. People I thought would be friends forever have grown apart. But then again, people that I thought could never even get along have become close. I've had some very close friends all my years in school. Stephanie, Brandy, Autumn, April, Matt, and Jeremy, we've been together since day one. We got in trouble together and had a lot of fun during days at High Rock, especially Miss Mary Ellis' class. That seems so long ago, but I remember those days almost I'll never forget. Yet the friends I've made at high school are the closest ones I've ever had. Hillary and Dawn, you are the two best friends anyone could ever come to have, and you're both like sisters to me. Natalie and Donald, you are the best teammates and twins that I've ever known. This past year has been very tough for me. Just knowing to have people like you that I could count on made it a little more bearable. Well, I guess it's time for me to come to a close. I want to thank Miss Sturgeon for all her hard work on this banquet, as well as the banquet committee. They have done an excellent job and went well above the call of duty. Also, I want to thank Miss Hatch, Coach Jackson, Woody, and Mr. Hawkins, not only for being good coaches, but also for being good friends. To all the teachers, thank you for the leadership and understanding you have shown our entire class. I used to look forward eagerly to graduation, but now it fills me with dread. I wish I could make time stand still for a while, but I know I cannot. We only have 2 weeks together, 2 short weeks. On June 1st, everything changes. Class of 96 will become history, and we will never again be together as we are now. We will go our separate ways, forge our own futures. I just want to say that I feel privileged to have known all of you, even if it was for just a short time. We have shared it all, joy, pain, and sorrow, and we've made it through. I consider all of you my friends, and I hope your futures are bright and filled with love and happiness. No matter where you go or what you do throughout your life, you will always have a friend in the class of 96, and you will never walk alone. Now, Jamie Johnson will end the banquet by singing our theme song.
Though you
Thank everyone for coming out tonight and being part of our last